Welcome everyone. My name is Hendrik Schröter and today I will present DeepFilterNet, a low complexity speech enhancement framework based on deep filtering. So these are our contributions. We propose to use a perceptual speech enhancement approach that works on full band audio. We have real-time capabilities and support latencies down to 5 milliseconds. The overall complexity is really low with only 0.35 giga multiple ads per second. The code is open source and we also have a demo which I will show you in the end of the presentation. So what do we mean with the perceptual approach? So we assume the speech model that consists of a periodic and a stochastic component. So what we want to do is we want to have two stages in our framework. The first one enhances only the speech envelope, and the second stage then focuses to enhance the periodic part of speech. So let's demonstrate this on this example. Here we have a noisy sample with some background noise.
Some have accepted it as a miracle without physical explanation.
And if we look at the enhanced version using only the first stage of the framework, now let's listen to this.
Some have accepted it as a miracle without physical explanation.
So you can hear that there's a lot of noise removed, but you can still hear noise superimposed over the voice parts of speech. So you can still barely hear the background noise. And when we zoom in, we can still see these horizontal stripes and their speech harmonics are not very clear. So now let's listen to the finally enhanced version using also the second stage, which focuses on the periodic component of speech.
Some have accepted it as a miracle without physical explanation.
So now the speech sounds a lot more clear and a lot of noise around the speech harmonics are removed. Now let's look at the framework. Starting with the noisy audio signal X, we transform it to frequency domain using a short time Fourier transformation. Then for the first stage, we compute ERB features, where we basically scale down our input spectrogram to ERB bands, resulting in only 32 ERB band features. These are fed into the encoder-decoder structure, where we have some convolutions and a GRU. And the output gains are also in ERB scale, so also only 32 ERB scaled gains are then applied to the noisy spectrum by scaling them back to frequency domain and just pointwise multiplying. So these gains are only real valued, and here, given the very coarse frequency resolution, we are only able to enhance the speech envelope. For the second stage, we compute complex features, because now we want to enhance the periodic component of speech and therefore need to modify the phase to remove all the noise around the speech harmonics. And then these complex features are fed into the DeepFilterNet part, which then predicts complex coefficient C. These are applied on the already enhanced spectrum YG and finally is transformed back to time domain using an inverse STFT. Now, before looking at deep filtering, I want to show you the network structure. So the first stage is essentially a simple UNet, where we have some convolutions that scale down the frequency dimension, as well as some GRUs in the bottom. We overall focus on implementing a very efficient DNN that has standard layers that we can also fuse together and has good support in inference frameworks. Finally, to get the number of parameters and especially multiple ad operations low, we focused on getting small DNN input-output. So for the first stage, we only have 32 ERB bands per time step. For the second stage, we have, I think, 96 frequency bins, so frequency bins up to a frequency of 5 kilohertz. And this allows to only have very low amount of parameters and especially multiple ads. And finally, we also use DNN sparseness by grouping So basically a linear or a GUI layer consists of multiple smaller ones that only process part of the input, and this greatly reduces the number of parameters and floating point operations. On the training details, we trained on the DNS3 dataset. We used 32 ERB bands, as stated before, for this first stage. And finally, for the second stage, we use an upper frequency of 5 kHz, since the energy, or the most energy of the periodic component, is below that. We use a loss and frequency domain with the magnitude part and a complex part, where C is a compression parameter to model the perceived loudness. I think it's 0.6. And furthermore, if you experience not number errors on the gradient computation, we also propose a way to make the gradient more robust to that. You may have a look at the paper then. Now, what is deep filtering? So what we usually do is we use a complex ratio mask where we have one complex coefficient per time and frequency bin that we just multiply with the noisy spectrum. What we use instead is deep filtering, where we have multiple coefficients that are then multiplied to the corresponding time frequency bins. And finally, summed up to get the current enhanced time frequency bin. So essentially, this is a complex linear combination, or a complex filter of order n. And in this case, n is 4. So essentially, a complex ratio mask is just a special case of deep filtering, where we have the filter order of 1. Now, when we compare deep filtering and the complex ratio mask, we can see in this experiment over multiple FFT sizes. So here, 240 corresponds to 5 milliseconds, and 1440 corresponds to 30 milliseconds. You can see that deep filtering outperforms the complex ratio mask over all FFT sizes, and thus also all frequency resolutions. And this is especially true for the low FFT sizes, where we have a low frequency resolution. So for instance, for 240 samples, FFT window size, we have a frequency resolution of 250 Hz, assuming a low male pitch of 50 Hz, we could have up to 5 speech harmonics within one frequency bin. And here the complex ratio mask really struggles to reconstruct the clean face, since we have 5 complex pointers that rotate in different speeds. And deep filtering, on the other hand, has now the advantage to incorporate to model the periodic, the underlying periodic signal, and thus is able to better reconstruct the original clean phase. And we can also see this behavior. We look at a qualitative example where we have a noisy input signal on the left-hand side. And when we look at the first or the third harmonic, we can see that it's barely visible in the noisy signal. Then in the middle, we can see an enhanced version using a complex ratio mask. And here we can see that it really struggles to reconstruct this harmonic. Finally, on the right-hand side, deep filtering is able to reconstruct this harmonic fairly good. So this, in the end, sounds more natural. When we compare this to related work, here we have PerceptNet, which also uses a perceptual approach using similar ERB band. First stage, and for the second stage, uses a comp filter to enhance the periodic component. Then DCCRN is a complex unit-like network, which operates in the complex domain, and DCCRN plus has some improvements, also including deep filtering. So they use deep filtering in the output layer. And finally, DeepFilterNet compares really or provides a really good performance complexity trade-off given the really low amount of multiple ad operations. We get a really good performance. on PASC, on the voice bank demand dataset. We have code, so we provide full code for training and evaluation of this framework, as well as some pre-trained network weights. We also provide a data loading framework, including ISTFT, STFT loop written in Rust, which can be easily used from PyTorch. So this, go check it out on GitHub. We have some new cool stuff coming up there as well. Also, we have some audio samples online where we compare DeepFilterNet using the first stage only, then DeepFilterNet using a first stage and a CRM stage, as well as finally the DeepFilterNet using the first stage and a deep filtering as second stage. So here you can listen to those different outputs. Finally, I want to show you a demo. So let's see how DeepFilterNet enhances my voice. Here you can record an audio signal, a speech signal, or also upload a different speech signal. And this will be mixed with a noise, which you can also upload your own noises. Then we can run the network on the Hugging Face hardware. And let's see how DeepFilterNet enhances my voice. This is the resulting mixed noisy signal. And when we listen to the enhanced version, let's see how DeepFilterNet enhances my voice. You can hear that most of the noise is removed. All right. These are my references, and thank you for your attention. Feel free to reach out to me, write me an email, or open a GitHub issue. Thank you very much.